So I'm focusing on the Imperial Hotel, which was first commissioned in 1915, demolished in 1967 in November, just before the 1970 Osaka Expo and the rise of high-rise buildings.
The Japanese print has inspired me. I never got over my first experience with it, and I shall never probably recover.
Frank Lloyd Wright. Wright had long been interested in Japanese art and eventually wrote a book entitled The Japanese Print and Interpretation. Not only was Wright fascinated with steel and glass, but he was intrigued by ferro, or armored concrete. All were newly discovered building materials, meant to replace the use of wood. Wright considered the concept of steel in tension truly liberating. With it, a square was no longer destined to be a square. He had the opportunity to test its capabilities when Baron Okura, chairman of the board representing the Imperial Royal Household, was hired to construct the Imperial Hotel in Tokyo.
Here you see no walls, only features grouped about an interior. And the ceiling overall coming through, so when you're inside, your vision goes out into the infinite in every direction. Now here's a ceiling, which is a flat overhead extension, and you look out from the interior through these side windows here, you see. You see, you're conscious of a whole sense of space.
That says the jewel of the Orient, and talks about it being a blending of both East and West, or actually that it is neither of the East nor of the West, but that perfect blending.
リー 満州国大使主催のもとに 記念晩餐会が帝国ホテルで開かれました。
The readily available and abundant supply of lava was used as the primary building material. Wright ignored the fact that using lava for an upscale hotel was considered sacrilege in Japanese culture. It was especially shocking that he wanted to use it to build a hotel for the royal family.
Neither East nor West becomes very important, I think, in understanding the greatness of the right design, and not putting him into a category, but really understanding this international experience that you would have had at the hotel.
Wright also saw Tokyo as a unique challenge to the entire field of architecture, given that earthquakes were an almost daily occurrence, and even a small quake could cause damage and kill people. Taking his own advice to know the client and the environment before beginning work, Wright learned as much as he could about Japan, firsthand. Among other things, he discovered that thousands of Japanese had been killed, murdered, he called it, by roof tiles falling during earthquakes. His solution was to replace roof tiles with a light, hand-worked copper roof. After all, as he asked, why kill more?
My father was in Japan on business in 1923 when one of the worst earthquakes that the world has ever known struck there, killing more than 140,000 people. Fortunately for my father, he was staying at the Imperial Hotel in Tokyo. The Imperial sustained some shock damage but remained standing because Wright had seen that it was built to withstand earthquakes.
A telegram arrived from Baron Okura in Tokyo, informing him that not only did the Imperial Hotel remain standing, it emerged from the disaster virtually undamaged. The rest of the note to Frank Lloyd Wright was priceless. It read, As monument of your genius, hundreds of homeless provided by perfectly maintained service. Not only was the hotel still standing to provide its patrons safe haven, but it was pressed into service providing sanctuary to the newly homeless on its terraces. Because of the Imperial Hotel's large pool, the only available water source was inside the Imperial. The bellboys formed a bucket line, drawing water from the pool for those in need and to extinguish fires. Like many, Baron Okura had lost just about everything else, but the Imperial Hotel remained.
The first pictures from inside Japan's devastated capital, Tokyo, three quarters wiped out by the superfortress attacks long before the atomic bomb. A city which once held 6.5 million and was to have been the capital of all Asia, now lies in ashes. Outside the Emperor's palace, almost wholly untouched in the American bombings, a few Japanese subjects worship. Overhead, American planes patrol.
The big dance that evening. As you watch the graduation party, you can't help but wonder if you are really very far away from home. For there is something solidly American here in this school system that embraces the whole world.
This incredible experience of entering into a world shaped by these materials, the Oya stone, a whole world of furniture, china, that are ordered and composed, but in a very dynamic way.
That evening was the night of the big Tokyo reunion. The class of 25 formally gathered in the peacock room of the Imperial Hotel in our orange color class blazers. There were more than 200 Princetonians in Tokyo with their friends and guests. It really was a gala occasion.
これ覚えてますね、僕高校生の時。
これも覚えてます。行ってれば見てたんだけど、
ロータリークラブの総会を僕、はい、ボーイスカウトで高校生なんか、道案内のボランティアでした時、これ、はい、ここだったんですよ。今ね、Meiji-Mura に、
ライトの建築のね。そうですね。そう、僕も Meiji-Mura に行って初めて入って、ね、この当時に入りたかったと思って今思えば。
I took a room, I got a room in the so-called New Imperial, which is right behind it, and about the second day, the workmen came out and put the scaffolding up around there, and here they are. Now, we could not withstand time.
So long, Frank Lloyd Wright, I can't believe your song has gone so soon.
See the size of the buildings that are all around us. Here we are with this tiny low building. So this turns out to be economically a very difficult situation.
So soon.
A lot of the furniture was thrown out of the windows. The workmen separated everything. It just hurt me so. I was crying. I didn't take enough pictures. You never can take enough.
it's still dawn. I never left so long, so long, so long. Architects may come and architects may go and never change your point of view.
The architect must be a prophet in the true sense of the term. If he can't see at least 10 years ahead, don't call him an architect. Frank Lloyd Wright.
Organic architecture is an architecture from within, outward, in which entity is the ideal. We don't use the word organic as referring to something hanging in a butcher shop, you know. Organic means, in philosophic sense, entity, where the whole is to the part as the part is to the whole, and where the nature of the material is the nature of the purpose. The nature of the entire performance, and out of that comes what significance you can give the building as a creative artist.